Today we're talking about investing in the event season in PokeMMO. If you want to get rich in this game, investing might be the best way to do it. I analyzed a lot of data from past events to show you the best ones. I'm gonna walk you through the three main investment categories and a bonus one if you stick until the end. By the way, I'm Zinedine, I've made over 900 million in this game and I think about PokeMMO money making all the time. And just so you know, I'm sharing the full spreadsheet in the description so you can verify everything yourself. First, we'll talk about sealed product. Now hear me out, let's treat this Pokemon game like a real market. I went over each individual item in the PokeMMO Investments website and analyzed over 50 Pat's event season streams, going frame by frame whenever he opened the GTL, to find the daily prices of each item from the 2023 and 2024 events. If this doesn't make you subscribe to this channel and like this video, honestly, I don't know what will. Sealed products, what are they? During the events in PokeMMO, players complete tasks and get rewarded with them. They are simply loot boxes. And you can open them to get items and vanities, cosmetics for your character. You see that for each event there are two loot boxes. One is harder to get and more expensive. And if you open these expensive ones, there's a chance of getting a rare vanity, which could be worth a lot. Therefore, their prices in the GTL are higher. The common knowledge about investing is to buy these items late to mid-event and hold it for at least 1 year before selling. But you probably already know this. You're going to see if the data confirms if these ideas are correct, and I will show you how you can get an edge and make profit investing even though the player base already knows these basic concepts. Now let's talk about the ROI. The best investment advice is to buy low and sell high. Simple, right? So is there a time during the event where the prices dip? Yes, the data confirms the common belief. It became pretty clear that this is the general price trend and the best time to buy is mid to late event. Makes sense. Players are accustomed to the event, the hype has faded a little and prices drop. So you can already take this advice to know when to buy. And all the analysis was made if you bought these items at their lowest. Trust me, it's a lot of numbers, but it will all become very clear. Now let's talk about the ROI from all the sealed products from 2023 and 2024 events in a one-time period if you bought them at a dip. You can see that they go anywhere from 20% to over 120%, and spotting the good and the bad ones is something I wasn't able to do. You can try though. But I wouldn't recommend you betting the house on a single one, which is a term that the PokeMMO Spanish community calls an inversión, and I always thought this was something Ukiora would say.
Inversión.
If you decided to invest everything into a single loot box, you could make between 20 and 120%. But here's where it gets interesting. If you diversified and invested the same amount of money into each one, this would be your ROI in 1 year for each event season. And here's what makes this even better. This is consistent. You're not gambling, you're planning. It's more moderate, but it's safer. In investing, getting consistent returns matters more than chasing big wins. The alternative to 60% isn't always 120%. Sometimes it's 20%. And personally, I would rather have steady gains than roll the dice. That's investing advice my grandma would take. So you can expect to make around 60% ROI in 1 year investing in loot boxes if you diversify. Anyways, another thing we can see is that knowledge about investing didn't make the 2024 returns worse than 2023. They were basically the same. And from now on, whenever I group an investment, just know that I diversified. But with this in mind, more questions can be answered. For example, is it better to invest in the cheap loot boxes or in the expensive ones? And here are the numbers. Now this clearly shows a difference between them. You could try investing more into normal loot boxes, but to me, diversifying still makes more sense. Another common sense about investing would be that more players would play the first events than the later ones. Which means the investments ROI would grow in the following order: Halloween, Christmas, and Lunar New Year. And here's the ROI grouped by event. The numbers would say the best event to invest in is Christmas, but honestly, this is limited data. It spiked because Xmas present 2024 did well. Still, we saw that Lunar New Year has bigger events than Halloween, but not by much. So the general sense can sort of be confirmed by this analysis. With that in mind, let's keep going. It might have come to you that I'm talking only about the ROI of the first year, but 2023 events already have 2 years of data. And yes, you are correct, you beautiful genius. If you held the 2023 loot boxes for 2 years, this would be your results. And it goes to show that if you're only willing to hold the loot boxes for 2 years, you would actually lose money if you held them for the second one. So the best strategy would be to sell in the first year and reinvest in the new events, but for all you know, in the 2 year and 1 day, the investments could go to the moon. And congratulations! This finishes up the analysis of this section. Before we move on, let's sum it all up to make it easier to absorb. The prices dip during mid to late event, and that's when you should buy them. If you put all your money into a single item, in 1 year you could make anywhere from 20% to 120%. But if you invest the same amount of money into each item, you could make a consistent 60% ROI. The data shows it's best to invest in the normal loot boxes rather than the premium ones. I don't see a clear event winner, maybe you do. And in a 2 year scenario, it would be best to sell your investments in the first year and reinvest into the next ones. I think this helps clarifying everything. These are the key points that you should know from this section. Now that we understand loot boxes, the foundation of event investing, let's move on to the items that made people really rich recently, the mysterious balls. These are also obtained only in the event season. If you open the loot boxes we talked about, you'll get items, and if you open the mysterious balls from 2023 onwards, you'll get Pokemon, but with a twist. They come with the best shiny odds in the game. Each ball has its own pool of obtainable Pokemon, and the odds for each of them change. The better the pool and the better the odds, the more expensive the ball. Now to the analysis. These mysterious balls with unbelievable shiny odds were introduced in 2023 and they follow the same pattern of price dip we saw in the loot boxes. There's no need to elaborate more on that, buy them mid to late event. And to show you how actually unbelievable they were as an investment, here's the 1 year ROI from the first set introduced in 2023. Amazing, right? So the advice is to sell your house and invest everything you have into mysterious balls. Just kidding, I'll show you how to spot if the next ones will be just as profitable and an investment that could be even better. So if you didn't know by now, mysterious balls were the best investment in the game available in a long time. But when they came out, even the most optimistic investor wouldn't expect them to be this good. They were new, there was no historical data to price them correctly, and looking back, they were initially undervalued. But this changed. Seeing how well they did, in the next year's event, players have watched carefully the next ones as an investment opportunity. This is the ROI from the second set. Premier balls were not available in 2024, and Dusk balls were introduced. As we can see, they didn't do as well as the first set, which is really significant and it makes sense, but now that we have all the data, let's compare the performance of everything we have analyzed so far in the first year. We can see that mysterious balls from 2024 were almost 3 times worse compared to the first ones, but they were still better than loot boxes. And this brings other questions, such as, will their ROI keep going down? And check this out. I'll show you an indicator to spot whether the next set could potentially skyrocket or just flatline. And that comes from asking a simple question. What caused the performance of the second set to be worse than the first one? Right now you're probably thinking, duh. It's because their price didn't drop as much during event season or they didn't reach the same peak. And that's precisely it, my good friend, so let's start with their lowest prices during the events. This was the floor price of the first set of mysterious balls. And here's the floor price of the same ones from the second set. I know, that's a wall of numbers, but stick with me, there's a simple pattern here. The floor price rose on average by 40% in the second year, and not to bore you with even more numbers, just know that their price after 1 year was 34% lower. So both happened, they didn't drop as much and they didn't climb as high. But the key point here to understand if their ROI will keep going down isn't actually the price they reached after 1 year. No, because I'm not including their absolute peaks here, which happens because of Shiny Wars, an event where players spend a lot of money to shiny hunt. Comparing their peaks here would make this analysis between years unfair. We'll dive into that and much more, like how their odds influence their prices, in another video where I can really break down each ball individually. And if you like this kind of data-driven approach, subscribing tells me to keep doing more of them. So click those YouTube buttons and let's keep moving forward. Here's how we spot whether the next set will be winners. If their floor prices keep going up because of player behavior, they could go down to the same ROI as the loot boxes. For now, you should know that they are a buy, especially if the third set floor price stays close to the second one. This is my opinion and I could be 100% wrong, but I think they'll keep being one of the best investments in the game. And this finalizes this section, so let's sum it all up. You should buy Mysterious Ball's mid to late event. The first set had unbelievable returns. Players understood that and the second set didn't perform as well. Still, the second set had better ROI than loot boxes. You should compare the next set floor price of the second one to spot trends. And a stupid guy on a YouTube video who made a bad analysis said that they are still a buy. This is what I think you should know about this section. So far we have loot boxes around 60% ROI and Mysterious Balls in a range of 96 to 271% ROI. And I would love for you to comment on the video about the best or the worst investments you've made in the game. I'm sure that a lot of players can learn from your story. All that said, now let's talk about fashion. Is it a good idea to invest in vanities? In order to make your life easier and mine harder, I went over 54 vanities you get from opening the loot boxes, the ones you get by completing tasks during the events, and the limited ones from the gift shop. Now let's play a game just for fun. I'm showing you on the screen 10 of these vanities. Can you tell me the ones that actually made a profit? Feel free to pause the video if you want more time, but I'll keep going. From all of them, if you only chose this one, you're correct. Here's my simple advice, don't invest in vanities. They're not investments, they're hype cycles. And let me tell you why. They don't follow a predictable pattern such as the loot boxes or the mysterious balls. Nothing I've seen indicates that in a 1 year period, their prices rise to a certain point. In fact, most of them drop a lot. Here's a cool fact, while a mysterious ball price graph looks something like this, they tend to rise up after the initial release. This is a price graph from a vanity, completely unpredictable. But wait, there's more. The money players make from them isn't by treating them like an investment, holding them for some time and then selling. Oh no 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 no. Money made from them is by pump and dump, good for traders, bad for investors. These traders create artificial supply, buying everything on the market and then listing them a lot higher. So yeah, vanities are kind of the shit coins of PokeMMO, and the only thing more unpredictable than them is my upload schedule. My advice to you is if you think a vanity is cool, buy them, but don't treat it like an investment. But if you're from the Balenciaga family of Cerulean and you have the god gift of knowing which one will rise in price because of their aesthetics, then by all means do whatever you want, I don't have these fashion gifts. For example, did you know that the lucky red dragon is almost double the price of the gold one? Personally, I would have never guessed that. But if this becomes a series, I will probably make another video about vanities alone. Do your part. Show me your support. Finally, let's go to the bonus tip, which could be better than everything you have talked about so far. To reward you coming this far into the video, I put an investment here that could even surpass the almighty mysterious balls. What you should know is during event season, there are limited/seasonal Pokemon, those being mainly exclusive alphas, and players get rewarded with them when completing certain content, such as raids or hunts. If you already know what I'm talking about, the important thing is I have listed the price of the most desired ones in this video, so we have a reference point to come back and see how good an investment you can make. Now zooming back, these Pokemon prices go up and down due to the supply and demand cycle. They drop to their lowest during the events and rise to their limit just before the next event season starts. So you shouldn't think about them as a long-term investment. Their cycle is 1 year. You buy them during event season and sell them before the next year's event season starts. Honestly, I don't have the data of their prices during the events, but these are the prices on the GTL just before this event season starts. You can see that some of them are more valued than others. The reason? Useful hidden abilities or Shalpha hunting. Here's the Pokemon I would tell you to keep an eye on. They are Chandelure and Gengar from Halloween, Togekiss from Christmas, and from Lunar New Year, especially Excadrill and Gyarados. Both of them have desired hidden abilities, and here's also the price of the cheapest one with them, just with the hidden ability not being an alpha. There's also another reason the prices for the alpha Pokémon of the Lunar New Year rise, and that's the Spirit of Spring Particle, which is a cosmetic for a Pokémon just like Vanities are for a character. Here's the lowest listed male and female prices for each egg group available during the recording. So there's a lot of opportunity here, and yes, these Pokémon could be the best moneymakers in the game if their prices dip enough during the events. Just be careful to sell them before the next one starts, but you can use this list I showed you as a reference. If a Pokémon dropped to like 50% of the value they show you, it might be a good buy. And if you master this timing, you might just become one of those mysterious billionaires no one knows how they got rich. Kinda like my grand. If this helped you understand event investing better, drop a like, and if you enjoyed this video, you also probably like this one, or you can binge watch all the videos from our playlist over here. I don't care, but the GTL does. See you on the next one.